island of Negros, life is just a bit sweeter. For 9 months, farmers wait for the sugarcane to reach the perfect point, ready for harvest, producing one of the key ingredients in Filipino food, sugar. For Chef Margarita Fores, this is a familiar scene. Her childhood summers were spent here at her mother's family home.
I feel that this whole journey that I've taken, the 30 years that I've been working with food, it always goes back to what I grew up with and what my heritage is. And I've had like my best food memories growing up as a child, coming back to Negros in the summer.
It's a mere 1 hour flight south of Manila to Bacolod, a journey she still makes frequently as a way to stay connected to her roots. Her great-great-grandfather, General Juan Araneta, first ran this sugar mill nearly a century ago. It was one of the first on the island, and now it stands as a reminder of the rich agricultural history here. 70% of the Philippines' sugar still comes from this region. Fores is visiting one of the oldest operating mills around, the Hawaiian Philippine Company, aboard their steam locomotive. Known locally as the Iron Dinosaur, it is fueled by leftover sugarcane fiber.
Originally, when they set up the big sugar mills here, there was a district. You had a mill, and you had a certain geographical area that supplied cane. And all the early mills had a railroad, and that was the most efficient way to move cane to the mills.
Definitely being here at the Hawaiian Philippines, it just like brings back all my childhood memories, spending summers here in Negros and smelling all the raw sugar every morning. And it's like being back in time. We Filipinos as a people, we're always smiling, we're always like hugging each other and showing so much affection. So I think that all the way up to food, it shows that kind of sweetness is reflected in the food that we eat, and we look for it all the time.
One of her favorite sweets is the piaya, and Fores never comes down to Negros without making a stop at her favorite bakery.
I wanted to take you to show you how we make piaya, one of the most iconic sweets that we have here in Negros. This grill is quite old, and this place is one of the few left that still does it the artisanal way. And Ernesto here has been making piaya for 40 years, and his son and his nephew help him. And basically, they start with an unleavened piece of dough that has a secret thing. Well, it's not so secret anymore because he told me that they put a little pork lard so that it allows the dough to be crispy. And they take some muscovado paste. It's mostly for merienda, which is, you know, the meals that we have in between breakfast and lunch or between lunch and dinner, because we eat all day.
With much of her family still living in Negros, a Sunday meal at her aunt or Tita Marisa's house is mandatory.
Everything is all set for you.
This house has been here since 1927, giving generations the perfect place to call home.
70 years. She was here when she was four. So she kind of grew up here and did all the cooking for them.
On the menu today, lumpias, a Filipino version of an egg roll.
We have a lot of garlic in our cooking. And the lumpia is one of the best examples of Chinese influence in our cooking. So she has the pork and the shrimp, a little soy sauce. This is the shrimp broth. It almost feels like there's so much laughter that's been, you know, enjoyed in this household. I mean, after all, there are 20 siblings through many, many years of celebrating meals together, not only on Sundays, but every day. And of course, the last thing that goes in is white sugar. Since we're in sugar country, most of the dishes are finished off with some sugar. So every day she makes about 100, 200 pieces. And she says that she's taught a niece already so that the tradition is carried on.
Once rolled up, the lumpias will be served alongside traditional sweets and washed down with hot chocolate, which is made by mixing ground local cocoa beans, toasted peanuts, and water buffalo's milk.
Tita.
Thank you.
So here in Negros, our lumpia doesn't have the sauce on the side. It's already incorporated into the mixture and inside the wrapper. And they say it's because people wanted to be able to eat it easily while sitting down playing mahjong so that their luck doesn't change, right? Yeah. I think that it's not just in Negros, I think all over the Philippines, but maybe a little bit more exaggerated for us here in Negros. Everyone's just sort of taking their last bite and we're already talking about what we're gonna have next.
Just ahead, rolling out the hospitality at a celebration of Filipino food.